Hi everyone, I'm Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to talk about Illustrator keyboard shortcuts. Are they really that important? In my opinion, the answer is yes. So to let you decide for yourself, first I'm going to run through a series of tasks in Adobe Illustrator using the menu commands and the tools and not using any keyboard shortcuts at all. And I'm going to go as fast as I can. And then I'm going to do the same exact process using keyboard shortcuts, again, as fast as I can. So then you can decide for yourself. All right, let's get started. So here's the design I'm going to use. I'm wanting to basically prepare this for screen print. I have some strokes in here. You can see those right here. And all of these pieces are overlaying each other. So I want to expand everything and I want to cut out each piece where they overlay and then merge each color back together and make it a compound path. So here we go. Okay, now this is already selected. Next we'll expand with object expand and run through that process a couple times to make sure everything's expanded. Then I'll go to Pathfinder, divide. I'll choose one color using my group selection tool and then select same fill color and unite those in Pathfinder. Then I'll go to Object, Compound Path, and Make. And finally, I'll go to Object, Hide Selection. I'll do that same process a couple more times by selecting the fill color, select same fill color, Pathfinder Unite, and Object, Compound Path, Make, and then Object, Hide Selection. And then the third time, I'll select one of the pieces, do select same fill color, Pathfinder Unite, and Object, Compound Path, Make. And then Object, Hide Selection. And then I'll go ahead and go to Object, Show All, and I'll just move these pieces so you can see how they are now. There's nothing overlapping anymore. Now I will say that I'm not used to using the menu commands and stuff, so I wasn't as fast as some of you might be with finding the things I need to find. But here it is with keyboard shortcuts. And for this, I'm not going to do much voiceover because it goes too fast, but it's the exact same process as what you just saw. One change I'm doing here is I'm using the magic wand to select the same fill color or similar fill color and then going on with the process. And okay, that's pretty much it. So here is how much time it took going to the menus and the tools, and then here's how much time it took with the keyboard shortcuts. So that first way, kind of painful, right? Keyboard shortcuts save so much time, especially when you're doing repetitive tasks. And keep in mind, you don't have to learn all the shortcuts at once. Just memorizing one or two a week will seriously boost your workflow. Here are the ones that I think are the most important when you're starting out. And by the way, I have all these in a cheat sheet in my Gumroad shop, and you can take a look at that down in the description below. First is the selection tool. Just hit V on your keyboard to get to that. Direct selection tool, just hit A. Pen tool, P. Type tool, T. The ellipse or circle tool is L. And then the rectangle tool is M. If you hold the space bar down and you click and drag on your canvas, you can pan around your canvas to different parts. And then the escape key will help you to escape from a text path. Command or Control Z is undo. Command or Control G is group. And Shift with Command or Control G is ungroup. Command or Control with 2 is lock. Command Option 2 is unlock all on a Mac. And Control Alt 2 is unlock all on PC. Command or Control 3 will hide the selection. Command Option 3 will unhide all on Mac. Control Alt 3 will unhide all on PC. And then Command or Control 7 will make a clipping mask. Command or Control 8 will make a compound path. Command or Control E will expand, and Shift with Command or Control E will expand appearance. You can also customize your own keyboard shortcuts. To do that, go to Edit, Keyboard Shortcuts. I have my own keyboard shortcuts set up for some tools and menu commands. One is under Tools here, and it's the Group Selection tool. So if you want to change this, just click over here, click again until it's dark like this, and then you can just tap the letter that you want it to be. Right now mine's set at G, and that's what I want, so I'm not going to change this, but I could hit F and it would change to F. That is already in use, so I'm going to undo it. And then I also have, under menu commands, select same fill color. So that's right here, and I've got it set up as Shift Command F. That would be Shift Control F on a PC. So you have the option of setting your own keyboard shortcuts, and it's really useful. So learning these will speed up your workflow. It'll make it a lot more fluid. And these are muscle memory. So once you really get them down, you do not have to think of them at all. It's just like typing. So yes, keyboard shortcuts really are that important if you want to work faster and smarter in Illustrator. I hope this video is helpful. If you liked it and you want to see more videos like this, just click on the subscribe button and the little bell next to it. You'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you next week with another graphic design video. Thank you.